Number three says, find, well, I could say a splitting field. The book says the splitting field. But remember, splitting fields are actually not unique, though they are isomorphic, it turns out. The splitting field of x cubed minus 1 over q. Also express your answer in the form q of a for some number a. What again is the definition of a splitting field? We start with the definition this way. Again, let E be an extension field of F, and let little f of x be a polynomial with coefficients in capital F, the smaller field, with degree at least one, meaning it's not constant. We say f of x splits in the bigger field if you can completely factor it in the bigger field. That's just the definition of splitting. But what's the definition of a splitting field? It's essentially the smallest extension of f in which you can completely factor, which you can always obtain by adjoining all those roots, a1 through an, using the adjoin notation. So, if I can find the roots of x cubed minus 1, I can just adjoin them to q, and that's a splitting field for this polynomial over q. Though it wouldn't necessarily be of this form because there's more than one root. So how do you find the roots of this? Something all math majors should know, but they don't always know. In fact, non-math majors should know this too, though they don't always know it, is that you can always factor the difference of two cubes. You can also always factor the sum of two cubes, no matter what those cubes are. You know, even if this were not a perfect cube, even if this were a 2 there, if I thought of it as 2 to the 1/3 quantity cubed, I could still think of it as a cube. It's just not a perfect cube in the sense of number theory. But it is a 1, and 1 equals 1 cubed. You can always factor the difference of two cubes as the first thing minus the second thing, without cubes, times a trinomial, where the first thing that's being cubed gets squared, then you add the product of the first thing and the second thing, x times 1, and then add the last term squared. What I'm trying to say there in kind of a convoluted way is, in general, if your difference of 2 cubed is a cubed minus b cubed, you can write that as a minus b times a squared plus ab plus b squared. Anyway, coming back to the example at hand, just simplify a tiny bit. That means x cubed minus 1 can be factored like this. So one root of this cubic is the number 1. So one thing we'll adjoin is 1, but you really don't need to adjoin 1 because it's already rational. The other two roots are going to come from the roots of this quadratic here. What are those? We can use the quadratic formula. Set x squared plus x plus 1 equal to 0. The quadratic formula gives roots negative 1 plus or minus square root of 1 minus 4 over 2 times 1. Oh, a negative under the square root. That'll be negative 1 plus or minus square root of negative 3 is I times square root of positive 3, where I is the imaginary unit. Negative 1/2 plus or minus I times the square root of 3 over 2. It is worthwhile, partially just to expand your knowledge of math, if you're not familiar with complex numbers, to think about graphing these numbers in what's called the complex plane. Imagine the horizontal axis is the real number system, and the vertical axis is, well, purely imaginary units. And these numbers can get plotted in this complex plane if you associate them with rectangular coordinates -1/2 plus or minus square root of 3/2, which I hope you remember from trigonometry are points on the unit circle. So if this is the unit circle here, plot those points, -1/2 plus or minus square root of 3/2 is going to give you those two points. In fact, you can identify these angles. That would be a 120-degree angle. What would that be? 2π/3 in radians. And this is going to be a -120-degree angle, or if you start from the positive real axis and go counterclockwise, you can think of it as a 240-degree angle. And the other root is 1, which is also right there in this picture at a 0-degree angle. All three points are equal angles from each other, and they're all the same distance from the origin. Isn't that pretty? If nothing else, that's worth teaching you just to illustrate the beauty of complex numbers a little bit. By the way, you can bring in trigonometry here as well and identify this as -1/2 as being cosine of 120 degrees plus or minus I, think of square root of 3/2 as sine of 120 degrees, and that is also, it turns out, the same as e to the I times 120 degrees, or more typically written in radians as e to the I times 2π/3. Where'd that come from? That's related to some things with Taylor series. When I teach Calc 2, I actually verify that you can say these are equal with Taylor series. You could take it either as something you prove if you have a rigorous theory of Taylor series, or you could effectively take it as a definition, though that seems weird. Why would you take that as a definition? It is also related to the most beautiful equation in the universe, e to the I pi plus 1 equals 0. In other words, e to the I pi is -1, which is the most beautiful equation in the universe, with the 5 most important numbers, the 3 most important operations, and the most important equivalence relation equals in the universe. It's worth knowing a little bit about. So what, getting back to the problem at hand, what is a splitting field for x cubed minus 1/q? Just to join these roots. There's 1. Let's give this root a name. I'm going to call it omega. Omega is -1/2 plus square root of 3/2i. It turns out the other one down here is omega squared. You can verify that. Hey, these three numbers, 1, omega, omega squared, they really form a cyclic group, because omega cubed is actually going to be 1. And omega to the 4th is going to be omega. And omega to the 5th is going to be omega squared. What fun. Group theory. It's a cyclic group of order 3. I guess back up here, I should have allowed for plus or minus angles in here, but don't worry about it. Omega also could be thought of as e to the I times 2π/3. And that does mean omega squared is e to the I times 2π/3 squared, and you would multiply the exponents and get e to the I times 4π/3. Anyway, using this notation, the answer for a splitting field is Q adjoin 1 adjoin omega squared. But we don't really need to write the 1 because that's already rational. We could write it like this. Q adjoin omega and also adjoin omega squared. But wait a minute, that's not quite in this form yet. Q of A, Q of just one element. We might wonder, could we get away with just writing Q adjoin omega? Would omega be good enough as our A? The answer is yes. Technically, we should prove that though. Definitely this inclusion for this equality is easy. right? That's the smallest subfield of the complex numbers. And you really do need the complex numbers here and not the real numbers, containing all the rationals and this complex number omega. Hey, that one is the smallest subfield of the complex numbers containing Q, omega, and omega squared. It definitely contains omega, so it's possibly bigger. Definitely not smaller. So this inclusion is definitely easy. The other one's a little trickier. How do you show this is a subfield of that? If we can show this thing contains omega squared, and then since that's the smallest containing both omega and omega squared, we'd be done. Oh, but that's not too hard. That's a field that contains omega, therefore it contains omega squared. Done. Omega is definitely in there. This thing is a field. That's enough to say omega squared is in there. And that's enough to say that this inclusion is true. These are funny arguments, but very subtle, but very important. These inclusion arguments that we've been giving with these fields obtained by adjoining roots. What's the degree of the extension? Omega does satisfy, is a zero of x cubed minus one. Does that mean the degree of the extension is 3? No. Because this is not an irreducible polynomial. I factored it. Omega is a root of this one. And that is irreducible over q. You can verify omega squared plus omega plus 1 does equal 0. It's a degree 2 irreducible polynomial over q. The degree of the extension is 2, not 3. And it is a finite extension, therefore it's also algebraic. No transcendental numbers in here.